Ladies and gentlemen, Fareed Kavari, Dr. Fareed Kavari, the author of Towards a Zero Cost Economy and Environomics, is here with us today. He is a gubernatorial candidate running for governor in the state of Florida. He calls himself not a politician, but an economist. For some, Dr. Kavari, that could be exciting, but for others, it could be scary because what's happening with the economy is scary. I've been going to your site, Zero Cost Economy. I've read your book on Towards a Zero Cost Economy, A Blueprint to Create General Economic Security in a Carefree Economy. And I see where you make three distinctions. One, you explain all the different aspects of economics from employment, energy, home ownership, businesses, insurance, healthcare, education, interest, taxes, environment, natural resources, poverty, retirement, economic security, and prosperity. And you go on in three categories, really, under socialism, capitalism, and carefreeism. And I think it's prudent to begin with your concept for carefreeism. Welcome to It's Rainmaking Time, sir.
Thank you very much. Good morning and good afternoon. The reason I have distinguished between socialism and capitalism and carefreeism, which I called the new system, is for this reason. In socialism, you don't own anything. The state owns it. And there is no incentive, and we have seen in Russia, we have seen in other Eastern European countries, and so on and so forth. And we see it in Cuba as well. In capitalism, the fact is, practically people have their houses, but you know how secured it is. Nobody practically owns the house. They don't own anything. If you fail to make one payment or two payments, they take it away from you. It's very insecure. In carefreeism, the idea is that people own everything and there is no cost attached to it. So once you pay off everything, you can own it. And everything should be also free. Now, I'm not talking about communism and Marxism and so on and so far. I don't like it, and I have to, when we get more into it, I will be describing about that. The fact is, everything is caused by cost. We have to first freeze the cost, then we have to reduce the cost, and then we have to eliminate it wherever it is possible. For instance, with regard to energy, we can eventually get rid of it for good. That will become energy-free society. You can get your solar system, and we have to distinguish between centralized and decentralized solar systems or energy system.
That's a good point. That's an excellent point about decentralizing. Talk about that for a minute, because it seems to be the heat of a lot of what's going on. All is about energy and its uses, aside from agriculture, but go ahead.
Yeah, because when we hear about solar systems and people talk about big plant, it is not in anybody's interest for many reasons. First of all, it cannot be free, because if there is a centralized solar energy system or wind energy system, you are going to pay for it for the rest of your life. And there is a chance that as time passes, the cost of energy will be increasing, as we see it with different power supplying companies. But if you have a decentralized solar system, that means that your house has, mine house has, and every other American house has their own solar system, then after we pay off that system, it will be free, at least for 20, 30 years. Let's say if we put today a solar water heating system, after 2-3 years, when we pay off for that, at least you will be saving $50 to $60 a month. And it can be devised in such a way that you can pay for it, pay less than what you save on that. Now, decentralized solar system will create jobs everywhere throughout the United States. It can be done practically tomorrow. A centralized solar system cannot. It will create not too many jobs, maybe 2,000, 3,000 jobs. If, let's say, if you put a big centralized solar power system in California or in Florida or elsewhere, and it takes 7, 8, 10 years to do that, and then you have to pay for it. Now, the third problem for the energy you get from it. Now, the third problem is, in case there is a natural disaster, especially in Florida, when there is a, let's say there is a hurricane, if it destroys a centralized system, it doesn't matter what it is, whether it's nuclear, whether it's solar system, wind energy, it will put us back to the dark ages, and it will take a long time to replace those systems. Whereas a decentralized solar system or energy system, if you had it, let's say a hurricane destroys 20,000 houses in Florida, but next day, 5 million other houses will be operating without any problem. So, and then most important part of it will be free energy for everybody. That is where you go towards the zero-cost economy. That is where you go towards the carefreeism and the carefree economy. Now, in capitalistic system, we have a problem. Everybody pays, and you say it, cost is the biggest enemy in United States. It's not Al-Qaeda. It's not caveman with atomic bomb coming towards America and threatening. It is cost that is destroying America, and that is going to implode in United America is going to implode economically because of the cost.
When you say cost, I just need to understand something. When one says cost, some people hear inflation. Do you mean that to be the same thing or different?
No, inflation is not the issue. Costs are that everything you are doing, your car, you have to put gasoline in it, it costs.
You're talking about a cost of living, correct?
Cost of living, everything. Okay. Cost of energy. Now the banking system, you know what they are doing? They charge you for every, if you are 1 cent, you paid less on your payment, they charge you $35 late fees. Now how many people can afford doing that?
Very few.
And this is the problem. And it is not global warming which is going to destroy America, because it's 50 years, 100 years down the road. Today, the cost will destroy America. And we have to stop that. This is the biggest enemy we have. And it's starting with the banking system, with interest, energy companies, with the energy, no matter how you look at it, whether it's electricity, whether it's gasoline, and so on. And then the insurance companies. Now everybody talks about reforming insurance, make it nationalize the insurance system, healthcare system, or privatize it. That is not the issue. The issue is how we deliver healthcare system at the lowest cost, however, the high quality services.
I want to tell you
the issue which we have to deal with it.
I want to share something with you interesting about that. You know how you talked about the decentralization of the delivery of energy?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I just did an interview the other day with Dr. Art Robinson, who has a 21st century medical diagnostics, almost revolutionary paradigm, but also to miniaturize apparatuses and to make access to the whole realm of diagnosis available to individuals, so that you don't have to go through, on a centralized basis, doctors and hospitals. In other words, it totally turns around the way in which care and health and medicine is delivered, and it decentralizes everything. But I will tell you that as exciting and riveting and necessary as that is, and how that could add to the, talk about adding a real global systemic, like base level need, right?
Yes.
To usher solutions and to have people be able to diagnose things that you can get thousands of pieces of information on rather than one or two. You're really talking about, for the powers that be, in considering this, a loss of primary control and almost dictatorial ownership over the rights for people to have basic needs met. And that's a whole systems change in thought, in deed, in structure. So how do you see costs being, how do you see carefreeism working? And I wish you could explain carefreeism a little bit more to the public.
Okay.
And then I can ask the next question, because it involves what you were talking about.